Kat is a third-generation sandblaster who grew up on a cattle ranch, who knows and understands the hard work and determination it takes to run a small business, navigate labor challenges, interpret regulation, and more. In 2011, an Obama-era program forced her family to lose their cattle ranch, evicting them from their home and livelihood. After months of homelessness, she was motivated to fight back against the failures of big government and dedicated her life's work to becoming part of the solution in Washington. Representative Cammack fights for Florida's 3rd District to ensure that no other family has to endure what hers experienced. Kat is a proud wife to her husband, Matt, a Gainesville native who serves at the Gainesville Fire Department as a firefighter, paramedic, and SWAT medic. Please join me in welcoming Congresswoman Kat Cammack.
Oh, stop it.
Okay, now who went to the baseball game last night?
No? What?
Oh, okay. You guys have a very good excuse. Christie's amazing. One of the best governors. Of course, I'm a little partial. I'm home to America's governor, Ron DeSantis, right? But I mean, that's pretty cool because when you think about it, our movement, we have so many incredible patriots, so many incredibly talented individuals who love this country and who are fighting for it every single day. I feel really honored to be here with you guys. And you probably don't know, but votes just got called. So my part of the program is gonna get cut a little bit short. So I'm gonna shorten up my remarks because I wanna hear from you. Because you guys are the future of the movement. It's you who are going to be on the front lines, taking the next step in advancing what freedom means in America. And I just wanna share a little bit about what we're dealing with today. We've got about 102 days to take back our country. 102 days, and we have to lower our shoulder and lean in and plow right through any obstacles in our way. Now, the reason I asked you about the baseball game last night is I play congressional baseball. It's for charity, right? Yeah. And there was a moment in the first inning where General Jack Bergman, he ran me through and, you know, we had a great hit and I was heading for home. And one of my Democrat colleagues was, of course, the catcher at home plate. And he got in my way. It made Sports Center this morning, is what I'm told. Well, I took him out. I basically just ran right over him. And they asked me this morning, they said, "What is that? What does that say?" I said, "That's a sign of things to come in November." Thanks to the awesome crew for throwing that up there. The video is hilarious. I'm 5'3". This guy's probably 6'2". And the look of just pure terror on his eyes is hilarious. My husband would say it's my little T-Rex arms that come out. But no, we've got an incredible fight on our hands, but I relish the opportunity that we have. And I know you guys too, do too. You wouldn't be here if you weren't in it hungry for the fight. Because we are the party of freedom. We're the ones that are out there talking about how we are a nation of equal opportunity, not equal outcome, and we can do absolutely anything that we put our mind to, including take down a 6 foot plus, you know, catcher at home plate if we want to. So when we are out there in the next 102 days, fighting for our nation, pushing back against this dependency and control agenda that Nancy Pelosi and Biden are pushing, when we talk to people about how the Biden regime has made us the least secure nation that we have seen in the last 100 years, how we are paying more for basic essentials than we have in 40 years, how they have crippled our economy, how they have made people more dependent on government and tried to take our generation and turn us into followers rather than leaders. This is our moment when we drop the shoulder and we plow right through their narrative, because we are the leaders. We are the ones that are going to be leading this country. And it starts in November when we take it back. Am I right? Yeah. Now, of course, I am known on Capitol Hill as Nancy Pelosi's least favorite member of Congress. It's a badge of honor. And I've worked really hard for that title, though. Let me tell you, I have put a lot of blood, sweat, and tears into earning that title, but it's for a good cause, because it's our country. And whether it is the police funding that she wants to take away from our departments, which, as you guys know, it's very personal to me. When I took my husband's SWAT vest to the House floor and threw it in front of them and said, "You want to take this off my husband's back? You're going to have to go through me first." That is the kind of attitude we need. And when they want to claim that abortion is somehow women's health care, they haven't had a whole lot of young women on the other side to stand up and say, "You're a liar, and that is false. And we will always stand for the life of the unborn. We will fight for those most vulnerable, because that's who we are." And today, actually, the vote that I am going to have to run back to the Capitol to cast is setting up the fight today. Nancy Pelosi and Joe Biden are coming after our guns. They want to put a federal assault weapons ban on the House floor today. And exactly. It's like they can't read some days, you know? It's like that whole part about shall not be infringed. They just kind of glossed over, right? But this is who we are. We are people who believe in life and liberty and the pursuit of happiness. We believe in the notion of equal opportunity, not equal outcome. And we will fight to our dying breath to defend the Constitution that has given the world, not just our country, but the world, the most incredible experiment in freedom and opportunity when you give people the rights, not just on paper, because we know they're rights that come from God. But when you let them free and you unleash that prosperity, incredible things can happen. And it's called America. So, are you guys with me? Are we gonna take our country back? No. It's a Friday, and I know that it's like 9 o'clock in the morning, but are we gonna take our country back? All right. Okay. I think I've got time for a few questions. Wow, that's tiger blood energy right there. Dude like ran to the back. Did you lower your shoulder? Wow, okay. I'm not mad at that, not mad at that at all. Let me see. I'm supposed to be looking for my chief of staff who's supposed to give me the cue when I have to run with my little T-Rex arms and legs back to the Hill. Okay, all right.
Students, once again, please state your name, the college you attend, and a brief question. Thank you.
Awesome.
Hello, Congresswoman.
High energy, man. I like it.
If you heard some whoops, they were coming from over here. Woo woo!
I like it.
Sebastian Griffin from Boise State. That's in nice. Idaho. Very happy to have you here. We were just having a very passionate and heart-tugging conversation on the discussion of Uvalde. Mm. And it's very convenient that you bring up that there's an assault weapons bill being voted on today. Mm-hmm. And this is going to be a broad question. You can slim it down. Your husband's obviously in law enforcement and has that perspective. In my mind, and I'm not a conspiracy theorist, even though two of them will disagree
You know, people who say that are tend to be.
The earth is round, in my opinion. We made it to the moon. But with a situation...
He's hiding his tinfoil hat.
You know, the aliens are talking to me right now, and they want me to ask this. No, looking at that, is it... In my mind, I think, wow, I just can't believe... Of course, the timing just would line up with something like this. What... Do you see a connection with something as tragic and terrible as Uvalde and the assault ban that's happening right now, mm-hmm. and and correct me if I'm wrong, and I won't get offended, 49 minutes of waiting for police force to enter into a building and then having a border patrol off-duty agent being the one to take it down. Mm-hmm. What's your perspective on this? What's your takeaway? I know there's not a direct question. I just want the broad Congresswoman Kat answer on this.
Well, thank you for that leeway, first and foremost. I think the question and the timing is very appropriate. Listen, I don't think a single person who has been following what happened in Uvalde has said anything other than, oh my gosh, my heart is broken. Those little kids, their families. I was reading the story about a man who lost his wife. She was a teacher in that school. And he died of a heart attack after going and planning her funeral. And they say it was because of a broken heart. If you don't feel in these moments, you're not human, right? And you have to look at these issues and these tragic events through the lens of, I'm an American, but I'm also a sister and a daughter. And you know, you have these emotions. The difference is that my instinctual emotion is to fight to prevent that from ever happening again and to protect. Whereas I see people on the other side of the aisle, their instinct is to take and to seize upon that moment for gain. The liberal left, their agenda has always been to disarm law-abiding citizens. Because I truly believe that their agenda is rooted in dependency and control. You put big government programs out there, you make people dependent on government, therefore you're going to control them. Right? You see them defunding our police departments while simultaneously wanting to disarm us. And we all know this is, I know, common sense, and common sense isn't common, especially in Washington, but criminals don't follow the law. They don't follow the law. Sick people who are intent on committing crimes of violence will do so by any means necessary. It could be with a knife. Hammers, unusually, are some of the highest use of weapons or favorite choice of weapons for people committing crimes. And of course, cars. We have a problem in this country that stems from mental illness. We have created a society where people, one, are scared to reach out for help. We have told every single person in this country that you deserve a blue ribbon, a participation award, and that you are special. And you don't have to do anything to earn the title of being special. Just breathing. And so we have taken away that very critical element that is needed in society. It's competition, it's adversity, it's grit. It's the thing that makes you who you are and builds that character, that resiliency. When you feel like you need a push or you need this, you can deal with it. We have created a culture of snowflakes, quite literally. And when you look at that kid who did this incredible mass murder event, this was a sick kid. He was sick, he was mentally ill. And there was no red flag law, there was no law in the books that would have prevented him from creating that incident. Because when you watch the video, and it was tough to stomach, I watched him, he went through, he was very deliberate in the classroom that he chose. He went to his old fourth grade classroom. I don't know if a lot of people know that, but he picked the room deliberately. And I heard through reporting and some of the official documentation that they think there was something traumatic that happened to him when he was in the fourth grade. There's an underlying issue when it comes to violence, and that's what we need to be tackling. But when you take and you start cherry picking what you want to uphold within the Constitution, that's when we're on the downward slide. And so if we're serious about curbing violence, just violence in general, we need to get to the root issue, not the little Band-Aid issues that people are gonna feel really good about when they say, oh, we took guns out of law-abiding citizens' hands. That doesn't fix anything. It's just a political talking point. So I hope that answered your question.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, we have time for one final question.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. It's Nancy Pelosi. Dang it. Calling votes.
Hi, Congresswoman. My name's Ethan Vogue, and I go to LSU. Go Tigers.
You know I'm the chair of the SEC caucus, right?
Good. Still beat you last year.
Rematch.
So first off, I gotta say, we all missed you at Freedom Karaoke last night. It wasn't the same without you.
Sorry.
And second of all, I need your expert and humbled opinion on a very, very serious question.
Oh boy.
Who was the MVP of the congressional baseball game last night?
Okay. I know y'all were with Governor Noem, who is amazing, by the way. We dominated, okay? Republicans dominated. The score was 10-0. It was literally a blowout. I mean, 10-0. And there were some incredible plays. I know I'm biased. I had a pretty good play. No, we have so many talented players. I mean, truly, we have former NFL players on our team. I mean, it's pretty awesome. August Pfluger from the great state of Texas. Any Texans in here? Everywhere I go, that always happens. I love it. No, August Pfluger, who's a good friend of mine, fellow freshman, he was awesome. And he actually did win the Republican MVP, and it was well-deserved. He made some incredible plays at third, but he also closed out as pitcher. So, I mean, he rocked it. And I love it because his signature piece of legislation is Midland over Moscow. He represents the oil fields in Texas. And he has been all over Biden to get us off of foreign oil and start our production back here at home. So for a lot of reasons, he's our MVP.
Thank you, Congresswoman, and go Tigers.
All right, guys, I know that my team is probably having a heart attack, so we're gonna do a mad dash back to Capitol Hill. But thank you for being here. Thank you for taking the time to come up to Washington, D.C. Yeah. No, and I say this earnestly. You guys are doing the inconvenient thing, taking time out of your life, your schedule, giving your time and treasure to be here. And it is inconvenient because you can probably think of a lot of other things that you could be doing rather than sitting in a very nice air-conditioned room, even though I love air conditioning, which if you enjoy this, think of Floridian because we invented it. Florida, where's Florida? Is there just one? Okay, we have some in the back. All right, Florida, we're gonna work on next year, okay? We need to like really represent. No, but you're doing the inconvenient thing by being here. And that's what's gonna be the difference maker. That's what's gonna make you successful. Because if success was convenient, everybody would be successful. So think about that. When it's inconvenient, when you really don't wanna do it, drop that shoulder and plow right through. And let's go take our country back. Thank you guys.